Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a topic that is on discounted cash flow analysis. This is like a universal method for, you know, valuation of any company. This is a universal method. Remember one thing. Here you have Alibaba's IPOs are discounted cash flow techniques and some of the valuation that has been done. This is the, you know, a screenshot of the same. Now, what is discounted cash flow? See, in simple word, discounted cash flow analysis is the process of basically evaluating the attractiveness of the investment opportunity in the future at present. You know, as a discounted cash flow valuation analysis, they try to calculate the value of the company, which they will determine over here today based on the forecast of how much the money company is going to make in the future. So in other words, you can say that DCF analysis uses the forecasted method, forecasted cash flow of the company, and discount them back as to arrive at the present value estimate, which forms the basis of the potential investment now. So let's start with this, how the step-by-step process goes. The step-by-step discounted cash flow process goes something like this. It is a 7 steps of flow. First, you need to project the cash flow. Then you apply the FCFF formula on the same. You need to apply the discounting rate to discount the free cash flow of the firms, and then determine the terminal value based on the last cash flow. Determine the present value of all the free cash flows to the firm and the terminal value's present value. You need to make some adjustment, and final is the sensitivity analysis. This is the 7 step of discounted cash flow analysis. Right, projection of the financial statement, then calculating the free cash flow to the firm, then third is calculating the discount rate, then the terminal value, present value calculation, any adjustments, and final is the sensitivity analysis. We'll start with the first thing as that needs is the attention while applying the discounted cash flow is the projection portion. Now that, therefore, you know, you can see that cash flow analysis to determine the forecasting period of firm, unlike human beings have infinite lives, therefore the analysts have to decide how far they should project its cash flow in the future. Well, the analyst forecast period depends on the stages of the company's operating and such as early to the business high growth rate, stable growth rate, and perpetuity growth rate based on which it works. So you need to project things over here. The forecasting period plays a very critical role because the small firms grow faster than the big firms. And so the analysts don't expect the firms to have infinite lives due to the fact that the small firms are more open to the acquisition and bankruptcy than the larger firm. What is the first thing that you need to do? You need to project the income statement. Okay, then you need to project the balance sheet and then the CFS. We'll start with the income statement. You know, here the analysts basically look over here for sales or revenue growth over the next 5 years, considering that the company, you can say that we'll be producing excess in return in the next 5 years. Okay, after that, the analysts calculate the after-tax operating profits and at the same time, you know, estimate the expected capital expenditure and increase in any net working capital over the forecasted period. So you can say that there is another approach called internal growth rate that comprises of return on the equity and the growth rate on the retained earnings. And over there, we take the combined growth rate comprising of both the top and the bottom growth rates. Then we analyze the balance sheet. Now, forecasting the financial statement is not done in the sequence in the discounted cash flow. All three statements are basically, you can say, interconnected to each other. And you will find that while you forecast from the income statement, you may have to move to balance sheet and then to the basically to the cash flow, etc. Right? Now, the next thing is the projecting to the cash flow statement. It's not necessary for you to project each and every item on the cash flow statement. Sometimes it becomes practically impossible to do so due to the lack of data. And the only necessary item from discounted cash flow point of view is the forecasted one. The next process that you need to go for is the calculate the FCFF to the firm. Now the second step in the cash flow analysis is to calculate the FCFF. Now, before we estimate the FCFF, we have to first understand what the FCFF is, which is left out after the company pays all the operating expenditure and required capital expenditure. So the company uses this free cash flow to enhance the growth such as developing new products, establishing new facilities, and paying dividends to its shareholders or initiating some share buybacks. So free cash flow basically represents or reflects the firm's ability to generate the money, you can say, out of the business, strengthening the financial flexibility, and that it can be potentially used to pay its outstanding net debt and increase the value of the shares. Then the next thing that comes into picture is the calculation of the discounting rate. Right, this is the next thing. Now, in this third step, what we are going to do, a number of methods are being used to calculate the discounting rate. But the most appropriate method to determine the discount rate is by using the concept of WACC. You have to keep in mind that you have to take the right figures of the equity, after-tax cost of debt as a difference. You know, just 2 or 3 percentage point in the cost of capital will make a vast difference in the fair value of the company. So take care on this note. You have KE, you have to calculate KD, and with the help of that, you have to take the weights and calculate the WACC, which is going to be your discount rate. Fourth, you will need to calculate the terminal value. Now, what exactly is terminal value, which is the fourth step in the discounted cash flow to calculate the terminal value? We have already calculated the critical components up till now in the DCF analysis, except the terminal value. Now, therefore, we will now calculate the terminal value followed by the calculation of the discounted cash flow analysis. There are several ways to do. One, the best way is to go for the Gordon's growth model to value the company. And, you know, its formula is like quite simple. It's like the final year, you know, cash flow. Okay, final year cash flow. And you will multiply this 1 plus the infinite growth rate. Okay, and you will divide this whole thing by the discount rate, that is your WACC, okay, minus G. This is the best way to calculate your terminal value. The fifth step in this is going to be of the DCF is the present value calculation. Now, in case of the present value calculation of the fifth step, find the present value of the projected cash flow using the NPV formula, that is the net present value formula, or you can go for XNPV formulas. Now, project the cash flows of the firms are divided into two parts. One is called the explicit period in this, and another is the period after the explicit period, that is post to 2020E, that is the post period. That so you will have to calculate both explicit period and the forecasted period, and you need to do the present value calculations. The final is the adjustments that you are supposed to make. This is a sixth step in the discounted cash flow to make adjustments to your evaluation. Adjustments to the discounted cash flow is done for all the non-core assets and liability that has not been accounted for in the free cash flow projections. And valuations may be adjusted by adding any unusual assets or subtracting liabilities to find adjusted fair equity value. What you need to do is you need to just adjust your assets and liability, like for example, non-core assets and liabilities not accounted for in cash flow projections. The enterprise value, that is the EV, may need to be adjusted by adding any other unusual assets or subtracting liabilities to reflect the company's fair value. Right. And the final step in the DCF analysis is the sensitivity analysis, the seventh step. Right, it is important to test your DCF model with changes in the assumption. This is very important. If there are any changes in the assumptions, the two of the most important assumptions that gives a major impact to the valuations are, first, the infinite growth rate, infinite G, and then there is a changes in WACC. We can easily do with the sensitivity analysis in Excel. You know, that's really very easy thing to do. So now we have come to know that the discounted cash flow analysis helps to calculate the value of the company today is based on the future cash flow. It is because the value of the company depends upon the sum of the total cash flow that the company produces in the future. However, we have to discount the future cash flow to arrive at the present value of this cash flows.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.